age of ballooning can be said to begin in 1783, when the Montgolfier brothers made their first ascent in a fire balloon. On the eve of their momentous ascent, the brothers took one last look at their craft as it stood on the fields of Annecy.
This is a great moment for us, Joseph.
It is a great moment for France.
Are we?
The first ascent in a hot air balloon by the Montgolfier brothers, 1783. I can see us now, just after Montesquieu and just before Mozart.
I think I'll go and wash.
Good luck.
Oh, it's quite easy, really. I'll just slap a little water on my
face. No. Good luck for tomorrow.
Oh, I see. Yes, you too. Yours has been the work.
Let us hope for a safe ascent. And don't use my flannel.
You know, when you showed me the plans in Paris, I could not believe that we should be the first men who would fly.
Yes, it's wonderful.
I'm so excited, I could hardly wash.
Yes, I too have had some difficulty washing these past few days.
Still, what is washing when we're on the verge of a great scientific breakthrough?
Jacques?
Yes, Joseph?
I've not been washing very thoroughly for many years now.
What do you mean? You must have been washing your face.
Oh, yes, my face. I've washed my face. But my legs, my stomach, my chest, they're filthy.
Well, I don't wash my stomach every day.
Oh, but you wash far more than me. You are the cleaner of the Montgolfier brothers.
This is nothing, Joseph. I may
be... Mr. Montgolfier? A Mr. Parfit to see you, sir.
No, a Bartlett.
Mr. Bartlett to see you, sir.
No, Bartlett with a T.
Mr. Bartlett to see you, sir.
Bartlett.
Barkett.
Bartlett.
Bartlett. Bartlett. A Mr. Bartlett to see you, sir.
I don't want to see anyone at all. Tell him to go away.
Thank you, sir.
Well, it's getting late. I must go and have a wash.
What will you be washing?
Oh, just my face and neck. Perhaps my feet and possibly... But no. Lock up the plans, Joseph. Tomorrow they will make us the toast of France. The first ascent by the Montgolfier brothers in a balloon. Just after Bullcock and just before Bang. What a position.
So on June 7th, 1783, the Montgolfier brothers had a really good wash. Starting on his face and arms, Joseph Michael Montgolfier went on to scrub his torso, his legs, and his naughty bits, before rinsing his whole body. That June night, he and his brother between them washed 17 square feet of body area. They used 1.5 kilos of carbolic soap and nearly 14 gallons of nice hot water. It was, indeed, an impressive sight. Next week, on the Golden Age of Ballooning, we examine the work of Glaisher and Coxwell, the English balloonists who ascended to a height of 7 miles in 1862 without washing. There is also a book called The Golden Age of Ballooning, published by the BBC to coincide with the series. It's in an attractive hand-tooled binding, is priced £5, and failure to buy it will make you liable to a £50 fine or 3 months in prison. There's also a record of someone reading the book of The Golden Age of Ballooning, a crochet-work bedspread with the words The Golden Age of Ballooning on it, available from the BBC, price £18, or 5 months imprisonment. And there are matching toilet seat covers and courtesy mats with illustrations of many of the balloons mentioned. Also available is a life-size model frog which croaks the words Golden Age of Ballooning and an attractive Baker-like case for storing motorway construction plans in, made in the shape of a balloon. And now, another chance to see episode 2 of the award-winning series, The Golden Age of Ballooning.